Unfortunately, the weather has taken a turn for the worst, as it often does in the tropics. The next morning, everything is perfect. It's time to explore.
I'm going for a swim. I've been very unlucky with the weather here. But today is a glorious morning and I'm going to the water.
Hajuan Beach is separated from its sister beach, Hatien, by a lightly wooded headland, over which we've heard you can find sanctuary.
Sanctuary has been here about 13 years now, maybe 14, I lose track a little bit, 13, 14 years. And it was just a restaurant, dormitory and two bungalows. And it was built by a group of people. It slowly evolved, you know, a bungalow a year kind of thing went up because it was a remote place. There weren't taxi boats all the time like there is now. There was times here when I was here when there was no food because you couldn't get out. You had to walk out and get supplies for yourself almost. It was small and intimate. Community kind of feel for many years, like 3 or 4 or 5 years even.
It's a traveling place, so everybody's travelers coming here. But they're also coming here for a bit the spiritual reasons.
On the spiritual journey, this is like a motorway service station on the M4 in England. You know, you're driving along, sometimes you want to recharge your batteries around beautiful people in a gorgeous location.
This was what I was looking for. I didn't know where it was. I didn't know that this place had a name.
I was guided here, and I feel enormously grateful for being here.
No road, have to walk through the jungle, and you wouldn't come over here unless you'd heard about it. Or unless, of course, you're just that not really looking at your Lonely Planet kind of traveler, and you're just an explorer.
Big seas, a 2-hour walk over a mountain, and boat ride. The journey getting here is part of the journey. It's part of, yes, you've reached sanctuary, and in the monsoon times, I'm sure you've experienced, you know, big waves, you get wet. It's an adventure, and it's part of it. You know, whew, we made it, yeah.
There's something very special about this place. All the rocks everywhere here. This is a huge crystal amphitheater. Everything comes up here. There is not a better place for leading groups, for doing transformative work. You actually don't have to do anything. All you have to do is hang out here 3 or 4 weeks. And all the stuff in your closets, all your skeletons, all that stuff you've got buried neatly away that you thought would never come up, will be right there.
This is a place of magic and miracles.
We're beyond the beach. We have spirituality going here.
We love this new community. It's as close as we've found yet to the actual beach, but somehow it's still not quite what we're looking for. We need to go even further. We decide to find a way to explore the Amphion National Marine Park, where the mythical beach is set. Okay, it's all pretty much set up. It's going to cost us 15,000. We're going to take a long tail boat, which is one like one of these, and we'll have to get water and provisions, and most importantly, we've got to find some people. We've just been talking to some of the fishermen, or the boat people, and I've negotiated a price to go out to the marine park.
Have you?
For the stay a night, yeah.
How much?
£15,000.
£15,000?
For the boat.
Right.
And a guide who'll stay with us.
Right.
Okay. But you can get about, I reckon, about five people.
Right.
So we can find five people willing to pay
£3,000 each.
£3,000, which is about 40 quid or something.
Yeah.
You get to do something that people don't normally get to do. And it's like an excursion or whatever.
Yeah.
Think you'd be interested?
Might be. Bit skin.
Got a another number for a speedboat here. Take us out to the marine park to stay a night. It sounds like it's reasonably priced. I think we were going to be overcharged for the long tail boat, plus the speedboat would be a lot safer.
Have you ever heard of the beach?
Yeah. I read the book and saw the movie, yeah.
Did that inspire you to come out here in any way?
Well, yeah. That utopian sort of idea.
Do you think this is it?
Yeah. But you can always get higher.
Yeah.
This is the closest I think I've ever come. And that's why I'm so happy.
would you want to get even higher?
Yeah.
No, we've got a speedboat going out to the marine park tomorrow. In theory, to follow what they did and try and find that there, to a place that nobody stays, and it's our own boat. We're just going to spend the night there. Can you be up for it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
That'd be great.
Oh, wait, it's here at 10 o'clock, man.
Tomorrow?
Yeah. You just borrow a hammock off your...
Yeah, I got a hammock.
...bungalow and, let's get your repellent, start bringing some water and a food to get through the day.
That's fantastic.
You're going to do it? Yeah.
I would love to go with you and sleep on the beach.
Absolutely.
With you. For all romantic evening.
Cool.
That'd be lovely.
Finally, we set sail with our three new shipmates, Jean, Svetlana, and Andre. Not quite what we expected to begin with.
You mean as a deserted island, yeah?
What did we come here to see, Nick?
To see the lake in the island.
It's called Emerald Lake.
It's 70 meters deep. It's connected to the sea.
Also have many sharks inside.
You can't swim. You can't snorkel. There is too many people. There's a bloody shop over here. This is not the place.
Yes, this is paradise right now. We're in paradise, but paradise never ends. I'm quite sure that the way it works is that you go from one paradise to another, to another, to another, getting closer and closer to the true paradise. But the funny thing is that you always climb and it never ends. There's always one place that's better than the place that you are at, forever. Understand?
Wow, this Emerald Lake is almost it. How many completely enclosed lagoons can you have around here? It's got high walls on every side, and yet it links subterraneously to the sea, so it's salt water. It must have been geographically what inspired the beach. The only thing is, there isn't actually a beach on there as such. We can't see any sand, and this place is definitely very discovered. So I guess we got to keep on looking.
Beach.
can't go behind, you'll be disappointed. So dirty.
Why? You mean someone's been here before?
Lots of people.
So you have to use the nature, you know, to be helpful to you. For instance, just take this.
Works.
Yeah, it works.
Fair enough.
Anymore, we've got the dinner.
Well, John has gone out and got us some dinner.
They're fresh oysters.
Yeah, but they're very small. We have to boil them, I think. But they're gonna be lovely.
He's the French Ray Mears.
This place is no good. I'll show you the place.
Go over there, west. Go to west, straight.
Mate, do you know where you're going?
Huh?
I have no idea, but I'm sure I'm gonna find a better place than this one.
It's gotta be able to dock there in the waves and stuff, so if it's exposed.
This is a survival trip, man.
No, go.
Alors les enfants, s'amusent bien?
With Jean still not satisfied, we go off in search of yet another beach.
Maybe over there.
Oh, many, many rock.
Many, many rock. Yeah, you can't get the boat close to it, yeah?
There's one, what about that? Looks perfect over there. What do you think? The tall trees, everything.
Okay, let's go there.
This is the place.
That's the omen, you see.
It does, I have to say, look very good. It's empty.
Perfect.
It looks like paradise.
And the sun comes like that. Yeah. That's the omen.
Me.
This is our forbidden beach.
Too excited to set up camp immediately, Andre leads the way to explore our new home for the night. While the island's certainly deserted, we find a shrine, indicating that this place has some sort of spiritual significance. Our resident shaman Andre needs no further encouragement to go to worship.
Yeah. Fair enough, dude.